Weazel News.
Wyatt Town in North Yankton erupts in bloodshed.
Can you whip up a souffle using only ingredients from dumpsters? Freegans are at it again.
A policeman fired for his Life Invader page. Several Chinese gangsters are dead, a grave was desecrated, and a town is scared and confused after a shootout at a cemetery in Ludendorff in North Yankton. Steve Pretoria at the scene.
Thanks, Sheila. The dead are mostly Chinese gangsters with links to a Chinese gang called the Wei Chang Triad. The grave that has been desecrated was the nearly final resting place of a Michael Townley, a bank robber himself killed in the last major shootout in the area 9 years ago. What caused his grave to be desecrated and the links between the two crimes remain a mystery. This is Steve Pretoria for Weazel News in Ludendorff.
A homeless man in Vespucci Beach says that freegans are the scourge of the community. These middle-class eco warriors reclaim thrown-out food. Freegans say we live in a wasteful society, and they are recycling food that would otherwise go to waste. The homeless in Vespucci promised to organize a protest.
These hipsters dumpster dive because they think it's cool. Making a quiche out of spoiled ingredients. They're robbing the homeless.
Loser news.
A policeman in Liberty City was arrested yesterday for taking pictures of victims at crime scenes and posting them on his Life Invader page. Officer Daryl Bent initially claimed his page had been hacked. Then he admitted he didn't even know what that meant. Then he said this to reporters.
Dead chicks are really hot, mostly because they aren't running their mouth.
Mr. Bent has been suspended.
Weazel News, confirming your prejudices.